When the campaign was proceeding in Iraq, I guess it was in the late spring, early summer of 2003, I was the commander of the 404th Civil Affairs Battalion. And in that capacity, my battalion was responsible for the three governorates of the Kurdistan region. One of the things that came out of that responsibility was having a relationship with the Peshmerga forces, who were the main force that we had in Kurdistan region. On the coalition side, my 220 some soldiers was the only coalition presence. So the Peshmerga had a much larger presence, and we had to have a reliance on them for a lot of the security functions. At that point in time, the Peshmerga, as was the Kurdistan Regional Government, was still divided. It was a divided administration left over from the internal civil war that happened in the 1990s in Kurdistan. And so we also had two branches of the Peshmerga. One was affiliated with the Kurdistan Democratic Party, the KDP, the other with the Patriotic Union of Kurdistan, the PUK. And as a spinoff of the combat operations, when we had, from an operational perspective, a very close working relationship with the Peshmerga, naturally, to make sure that the military activities were coordinated, that there weren't blue on green or blue on blue kind of incidents between the U.S. military and the Peshmerga. There was a close coordinating mechanism. When we transitioned from the operational side of things to the more stability side of the operations, we actually continued that coordination that we had with both of those Peshmerga elements, KDP, PUK, and my unit from the U.S. military. So we had a routinely ongoing weekly meeting between the different Peshmerga elements and myself and other officers and NCOs from my command. And the meetings were generally, again, mainly coordinating to make sure activities between the Peshmerga and us and between themselves were coordinated. But there came a time when that meeting became very important. And I would say it was in the early summer of 2003. And that was at a time phase in the overall Iraq campaign when I think people were still having very high ideals and very high expectations of what could happen. The insurgency hadn't really started. There hadn't been the huge security problems in the south. In the southern part of Iraq that later came into play. And so people were setting the bar in Baghdad pretty high for what they expected. And I think a lot of people were also coming to the table with the experience they had from the Balkans of how we dealt with Bosnia, how we had dealt with Kosovo in terms of how militias and other armed groups were handled after the periods of fighting were finished. And so that same thinking was beginning to be imparted on Iraq as well. And there were many people that were saying in Baghdad, we need to do something about these militias. We need to do something about these armed groups that are outside of the official scope of the Iraqi security forces. And there were people in Baghdad talking about the Peshmerga in that same context, that the Peshmerga were on the same level of playing field as some of the recently formed militias and party-affiliated organizations that were operating in the south, without realizing that there was actually a basis of law from the Kurdistan Parliament that gave the Peshmerga an official sanction. And so, like I said, we saw that coming, that there were people talking about trying to find a way to demobilize the Peshmerga, to make them stand down and go back into civilian life, and let the Iraqi security forces be responsible for Kurdistan as well as the rest of Iraq. Well, as people and as soldiers who were experiencing the benefits of having the Peshmerga in place, because as I mentioned, they were providing the major security for Kurdistan. It certainly wasn't my soldiers in my civil affairs battalion. But we realized that we had to get the Peshmerga on board in being able to lay out their place in the scheme of things, to tell the coalition, what their history was, their long history in terms of 20, 30, 40 years ago, their more near recent history in terms of what they had done specifically in Operation Iraqi Freedom, but then also their vision for where they saw the Peshmerga going forward, what kind of role they would play in Kurdistan going down the road as a region within Iraq. So it was in one of these Peshmerga meetings, these joint Peshmerga meetings between the two sides and us, where, again, in the summer of 2003, we basically gave them the mission, lay that story out for us, put it in your words from your experience, tell the coalition through us who you are, what you've done, why you're important, and why you should continue to be a force to be reckoned with. And I was very pleased to see that they took that challenge to do that very seriously. And they formed a committee with members from the two, you know, main elements. One of my officers and part of his staff from the section within my battalion staff acted as basically mentors for them in helping them to put that together. But within a not too long of a period of time, put together a pretty comprehensive report, which laid all that information out in a very clear and concise way. And I think opened a lot of eyes as that report went up the chain of command, not only to my higher headquarters in Mosul, but I know it went to Baghdad, and I know it ultimately went to the Pentagon in terms of the people that were reviewing that report. And I think it helped turn around the thinking that, you know, the Peshmerga is not a force that just was in history, but it is something that we need going forward as well. And I think may have played a role in helping to cause the coalition, the U.S. forces in particular, to realize we need these guys. So I think that was a moment that the soldiers in my battalion were particularly proud of in helping to be able to achieve that result.